Tuomas from WOLFHEART'S and Before the Dawn, and you are listening to That Metal Interview Podcast.
And we have a band from Finland, Before the Dawn. Awesome melodic death metal, if that's what you're into. I am for sure. And we have Tuomas from the band Before the Dawn. And he also has another band by the name of WOLFHEART'S. And they have a brand new album, Stormbringers. Napalm Records, you guys can stream it now. You guys can find it. And right now, they have a single by the name of The Dark. And here is the video for Before the Dawn, title, The Dark. Enjoy. Did your ears bleed like mine did? True death metal, melodic that is, and that's the song The Dark. You guys can stream it, download it, purchase it, support the band. Before the Dawn, Napalm Records, look them up on socials. If you guys want to purchase merchandise, go check them out live in any part of the globe, as metal exists in all the world, the whole world for sure. So anyways, let's go to the interview with Tuomas of Before the Dawn and WOLFHEART'S, as he speaks about different stories and he speaks of Stormbringers, their brand new spanking album, melodic death metal for you guys. Here is Tuomas of Before the Dawn. Enjoy. So first question, what part of the world are you at?
I am home in Finland, in southern Finland. We are having our rare weeks of summer in this cold, godforsaken country.
So it's cold over there?
Well, it's 7 months of the year. It's just winter or like a fall or super early spring. So it's kind of like a joke that we have 2 weeks of summer every year, and this is probably the first week that we're gonna get. It's not the warmest country in Europe.
Yeah, I read about it. So before we get into your new album, I want to ask why the big hiatus, the 10-year wait, and how did this come together after nine years, I think, or 10 years?
Well, actually, it's 11 years that we released music. We broke up 2012, and we were never supposed to do any music again. So it was like a very sturdy decision that we are done and buried, and everybody continued on their own path, and I started WOLFHEART'S, and you all went to play guitar in Swallow the Sun and so on. And two things led to this accidental comeback. We never planned to do it, but the pandemic changed a lot of things. Me and Juho, both when the WOLFHEART'S and Swallow the Sun tours got cancelled, we lost over 200 gigs. Wow. in a hard. And so that opened up a lot of doors to like a new schedules and plans, because we were supposed to be constantly on tour with our bands. And then Paavo, the new vocalist, performed one of our old songs in Finnish national TV in The Voice of Finland.
Okay.
And that started the whole process. Like we didn't even think that we weren't looking for a vocalist, but somehow his performance in TV and how well he did the song kind of like started the whole thing, that he chose us in a weird way. He started the whole process, and the pandemic allowed us to do so, because there was way too much empty months in the calendar.
Yeah, so that was one of my questions. How did you find this vocalist, Paavo? Right?
Yeah, completely accidental. I don't wow. follow these kind of programs on TV at all. I don't like the concept behind it. And I get a phone call one night. Juho, the guitar player, is calling me that turn on the TV. There's somebody doing one of our songs, and that was the first time I ever saw or heard Paavo singing. And we started to be in contact. I gave him a lot of compliments of the performance, and during the competition we were in contact.
Yeah, you were in contact. Yeah. I lost you like for 10 seconds.
I was in contact with him during the Voice of Finland competition. He went to the finals, he came second. When he was done, I suggested him that we could try and make some music together, that I might have some ideas that would work for his vocals. And we went to the studio, we finished the song, and when I was driving home from the studio, it clicked in my head that this sounds like Before the Dawn. It sounds like Before the Dawn should sound. And then I started to make a lot of phone calls for the ex-members from the past 11 years, and like testing it out, like, what do you think about this? I just got this crazy idea in my head that this sounds like the band that doesn't even exist anymore. And that's how it all started. The first song that was written for the new Before the Dawn album was not even meant for Before the Dawn. That's how little we planned the whole thing.
Wow, so it's all accidental, just by chance.
It is. usually doesn't happen in music business. In music business, everything is calculated and planned and negotiated, and a lot of struggle, and it's been very like refreshing to be in part of this kind of thing that just a lot of things just happen on its own.
Wow, so at what point did you guys start writing the Stormbringer the new album Stormbringers, dropping June 30th, by the way. Did you guys write that album in how many rehearsals, or how long did that take to write?
Well, that was a little bit kind of like a weird process, because we didn't play together for over a decade. We didn't feel like this nostalgic festival gigs, but we didn't really play together, or naturally we didn't plan to do any music or any gigs, so we weren't prepared to like work together in that sense. And we put the video out of the song Downhearted. That was the song I wrote for Paavo that accidentally became the first song of Before the Dawn. And we just put that out as a standalone single. And 2 weeks later, we have a contract from Napalm, booking agency for Finland, festivals and some tours offered. So we can like just notice that apparently we need to do an album. Because again, a lot of things, like we're also pushing with the comeback that we didn't plan. We weren't in contact with any of the promoters or labels. So it's just like suddenly we had so many things on the table that it made most sense to actually do a comeback. And then I started writing the songs, and actually the first rehearsals of the band was just like 4 months ago.
Yeah.
The album was recorded. Album was recorded and mixed before we ever got to the same room and played together.
Okay.
So everything worked a little bit differently with this album.
Wow. So why are you on drums now? What happened there?
Well, I used to play drums quite a lot when I was younger. I played the drums most of the Before the Dawn albums in the past. I had some other band. I played mostly drums on almost, how do I say it?
Most of the albums?
I played drums at least on 12 albums that I wrote myself. So
yeah, wow.
I'm the most, how do I actually say that? All the albums that I wrote or have written, I'm the most frequent played drummer on those albums, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
I used to play drum a lot in different bands and my own bands and also on most of the Before the Dawn albums. I just never played drums that much live. So yeah. In a back catalog of Before the Dawn, there's a huge amount of songs that I played the tracks on the album as a drummer, and I always wanted to play those songs as a drummer. But as a main vocalist, that doesn't really work out, that you do the growling and the drums. So I was kind of like, in a way, stuck with the guitar and with the frontman role. Now that there was the opportunity to step back, I could choose either just play guitar and do some occasional growling, or do the drums. So it was no brainer for me. Of course, I chose the drums, and I think that makes the change a little bit more clear for the fans also, that there's just one guy stepping in for the vocals, and I'm not there messing around anymore. I have WOLFHEART'S still, where I'm the frontman, so I get enough of that. Anyway, so yeah. I had all the reasons in the world to be the drummer.
So do you think this album sounds like Rise of the Phoenix, or would you say it's a little bit different? Did you guys take a fresh start when you were writing the stuff, or?
It's kind of like both. Fresh. It was fresh already because of the new vocalist and all the ideas he was bringing to the table with the vocal lines and growling arrangements and rhythms. But we wanted to go a little bit back, like more back into the roots of Before the Dawn. So to us, the album is more in the middle era of the band, like 2005 to 2009, with albums like Deadlight or Soundscape of Silence. Rise of the Phoenix, to me, was my transition to WOLFHEART'.
Okay.
That differs quite a lot from the previous Before the Dawn albums. It doesn't have any clean vocals. There's a lot of blast beats, a lot of faster bass drum. It's more like a melodic death or black metal influenced album. So any song from Rise of the Phoenix could fit to any WOLFHEART' album. But then again, any Before the Dawn songs from the new album could fit to any of the older albums. So it's kind of like underlining the right, like the core style of Before the Dawn. That's what we wanted to do with the new album.
So how many new songs are you guys going to start playing live?
We are already playing four songs.
Four songs?
Live. We started playing festivals already in Finland, and we had one comeback show for Finnish fans, and we did one European comeback show in Switzerland. And we wanted to add as many songs as possible, of course, to us, those are like last time we released the album was 12 years ago.
Yeah.
So those songs don't feel fresh in that sense. Of course, we love to play them, but the excitement of the new album is a little bit stronger because there's such a long gap between the albums now. And also, it's the best way to test the new material with the audience.
Wow.
Like if the first songs go as well to the audience as the old songs, then we know that we did a good job with the songwriting, and we've been super happy to see that that is actually the case.
Will we see Before the Dawn in the US sometime?
I hope. I really hope, because I never get to play a single show in North America with Before the Dawn before we buried the band. And now I already done 3 tours with WOLFHEART, and I really love touring in North America. It's completely different like a thing than touring in Europe. And I don't want to like talk bad about touring in Europe, but there's nothing more boring than touring in, for example, Germany. That's all the same. That's nothing changes, basically. Only if you go in very deep in the East Europe, then there's a different, a little bit exotic thing. But what I really love about North America is like every European normal person have seen a lot of movies about like different parts of America.
Yeah.
And we know the stereotypes.
Yeah.
When somebody mentions like Texas, New York, Florida, New Orleans, everybody has the image already in the head. We've seen those places. We've seen the climate, we've seen the nature. And when you actually get to tour around the whole country in 1 month, seeing every morning you wake up in a different like a scenario that you kind of know, but you never been there. I just love the, and it's, you have such a weird things. Like last tour, I was introduced to Buggies.
Oh yeah,
that's the coolest gas station ever. I even bought the squirrel onesie.
Yeah, that's a cool truck stop. Yeah, yeah.
So I would really really love to not just bring the band, but share the experience with the other members of Before the Dawn. That would be such a cool thing.
That'd be great.
I'm working on it. Your country doesn't make it too easy with the whole visa process.
Yeah, it's a hassle, I heard, yeah. So
it's 10 times easier to go to Russia and play.
Really? Wow.
Even with the visas. I've done that several times, and that's like 10 times easier. So but yeah, that would be one in the bucket list.
Bucket list for sure, yeah. Hopefully we'll catch you guys here soon. So speaking of Stormbringers, which is your favorite song on here?
Would be really difficult to name one. As a drummer, I like Destroyer the most. Into the abyss, fragility's destroyed. In a blink of an eye, the chaos is restored. I really like the energy on the song, how it's like constantly pushing forward. If I listen to the album, I would say Downhearted. Or Wait. But if I would have the budget to make another music video, then my favorite would be Reveries, because that would give me the best like visual concept. So there's, I have different perspectives for each song, and would be impossible to name just one.
Yeah, it's kind of like picking one of your kids, your favorite kid.
Yeah, that is.
So speaking of your talent, Tuomas, how old were you when you first picked up an instrument? Was it the guitar or the drums, or how old were you?
It was guitar, and I was 7 years old.
Oh wow!
That's
your kid.
I took guitar lessons for 2 months, and then I realized like. It's much cooler to write your own stuff than try to learn what others are already playing. But I still remember kind of like my first sort of a song. It was just 3 chords in a row that had the most basic, like nothing fancy. It wasn't like any like a sign of a talent at that point. But that's when I realized that this is much cooler to just build your own stuff instead of learning like songs that are already written. Of course, the guitar teacher was super smart, and he noticed that I'm not too excited of learning of the other stuff, but he taught me really good like basic techniques and stuff like that, so I could just keep on learning on my own. So I didn't pick up any bad techniques or bad training methods, but I don't know anybody else's songs as mine. That's the downside.
Yeah, you're original. That's all it is, and you never try to learn a Kiss song or anything like that. Yeah, that's cool.
One of the only riffs that I learned when I was a kid was the main riff of Enter Sandman.
Oh yeah,
I still play that in the soundcheck.
Yeah, who doesn't like Sandman? Who doesn't like Metallica?
Actually,
I've met one person that doesn't like Metallica. But so speaking of Before the Dawn, I saw the videos, your newest videos. Where did you guys shoot those videos, and who directed those?
We did the videos in the same venue where we ended the band 2013. We had this big, a burial party. I had three of my bands playing in there, and that was also the venue where we did the comeback show. So it was also kind of really cool. It was 10 years roughly between those shows. It was the same venue, same producers, same promoters, even the same sound guys. So it was really cool, completing a circle kind of thing. And also we wanted to do the video there. It is, it's the hometown of the band, and it's the venue of the place. And we did actually all three videos. The third one came out today.
That's right.
And the footage is actually from the gig, and the two other videos we shot in two different locations at the same venue before the show.
Wow, very cool videos. I love the music. I'm really digging it. It's metal.
And also,
it's nice. I love it. I'm a fan, so congrats on that for sure.
That's good to hear. The direction thing, I directed and edited all the videos of Before the Dawn and WOLFHEART'S.
Okay, wow.
It made sense also. I really enjoy the visual side. When the song is done, I have another layer to work with when I get to do the visual thing with the video. So I get to work double amount of time with the music in a good way. I don't need to give away the album because I instantly start working with the visual side. But also there's one guy who did a video for Before the Dawn 15 years ago. It cost a lot of money and it was completely shitty. One of the shittiest videos I've seen. And sadly, it was for my own band. And then I decided if we pay this amount of money and this is the result, this cannot be that hard. And I can just learn the whole thing myself.
Nice.
And that's when I started to do the videos myself, because at least then I know that if I fuck up with the idea, or the production, or the lights, I can compensate that with just extra work with the editing or something. I would never put out anything shitty in the name of my band anymore. So
exactly, yeah, very good point. So here's a different question: if you could time travel in time, we don't know if it's possible, right? If you could time travel, where would you go to, and which year?
That's a good one. I think everybody sometimes just entertains him or herself with the idea that if you would be able to go back to your childhood, would you live your life differently? That's if I would have some extra lives, I would like to try that out. Where would I end up if I did things differently? But I would really like to see the future. I would really like to jump 200 years ahead, just to see if the Earth exists anymore. I love science fiction movies. Everything is connected with the space or dystopia or whatever. I've seen them all, so I'm super excited to see what's gonna happen in the future. So I would go to 2300 or 200, just to see, do we exist anymore?
Wow, very cool. Yeah.
It doesn't look good at the moment. It doesn't look good. Of course, Finland is right next to the Russian border.
Yeah.
They are fucking the whole Europe with the war in Ukraine. So, at the moment, from my perspective as a Finnish person, I'm not super confident that the human race will exist for the next 200 years. But yeah, that's where I would go, definitely.
Wow, very cool answer. A lot of artists ask the same question. They pick stuff from the past, but it's very exciting to see what the future holds. And hopefully we don't blow ourselves up, with nukes and all that. So hopefully all those wars end.
Everybody knows at least some level of the past. There's history books and stuff. So you can learn from the past.
True.
Nobody knows the future. Sure. So that's where the big questions lie.
Awesome. Very cool answer right there. So give us an update on WOLFHEART'S. What's going on there? When is the next gigs there or the next recording? Give us an update on that, please.
We are playing like the busiest festival summer ever. We are mainly doing like European shows and few Finnish festivals. Then there's going to be a Finnish tour, both WOLFHEART'S and Before the Dawn, the same tour in October. And November, we're going to do European tour together.
Wow.
And we're gonna release a standalone single somewhere in September, which we are supposed to start recording in 2 weeks. So while Before the Dawn is super busy and the album is coming, like, I'm busier than ever with WOLFHEART'S. So,
yeah. Wow, you're juggling two bands. How do you do that? You just schedule carefully, huh?
Schedule carefully and cross your fingers. That's the. We'd be super lucky this year that none of the schedules are colliding, even with U-Haul from Before the Dawn being part of Swallow the Sun, that they are always busy touring and playing festivals. So the whole year, none of the schedules are overlapping. So I think it's just super lucky. Next year, who knows what's going to happen.
Wow, very cool. Very cool life you have. A true musician, 100% into the music business and dedication, that's awesome. Thank you for bringing great music, you know, great metal for us fans, you know.
You are all welcome.
So what's next on your agenda, Tuomas? What's coming up next for yourself and the band? What can fans expect?
Well, we are finishing the festival season with both bands. We are flying to Lithuania tomorrow with WOLFHEART'S. And the album is coming out. That's my main focus at the moment. There's only 2 days before the new album is coming out. So that's I can't really think further at the moment, because now it's just the last minutes to do the promo and try to push the pre-orders, and just got the video out. I see a lot of interviews for tonight and tomorrow. So I can't think further. Friday is the day, and then when that is done, then I look more what is in the calendar. But yeah, Before the Dawn is also doing like a festivals, Finnish tour, European tour, so we are completely booked until December.
Wow, very cool. Before we let you go, would you like to send a message to your fans and friends listening to this podcast?
Yes, I would like to. Never was able to bring the Before the Dawn to North America before we disband, so that's my main goal now, to bring the band and get to play to you all.
So in a couple of days, June 30th, fans are going to see the release of Stormbringers Before the Dawn, the return, and awesome music. I got to listen to it, and the fans are really going to like it. So thank you, Tuomas. Thank you for your time, and thank you for producing great, great music. Awesome future here for both bands, for all your projects. So thank you for all that.
Thank you. It was all my pleasure.
Thank you, Tuomas. We'll see you in the U.S. soon, hopefully.
Awesome. Bye-bye.
We are truly appreciative of this brand new reunion that happened without intent, if I can say that, as Tuomas told us about how this reunion came about and how they found their vocalist, present day vocalist, that is. And anyways, long story short, go ahead and swing by their social media, check them out live, buy their albums, t-shirts, merch, etc. You know what to do. Thank you, Tuomas, from your friend James, all the way from the state of Texas in the U.S. of A. And to all the newcomers, the first-time listeners to That Metal Interview podcast, thank you guys and girls for your brand new support. You are more than welcome, and we hope our content is of your liking as we speak of rock and metal. All kinds of rock and all kinds of metal and death metal. So anyways, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on social media, blah, blah, blah. You know what to do, right? So thank you guys and girls one more time. And don't forget to keep it metal.
That Metal Interview.